We've been getting a lot of great questions through our social media channels about our crash test programs and our other research, but one keeps coming up over and over again, which relates to our test speeds, in particular our frontal crash test speeds. People are wondering why we test at 40 miles per hour when people are out there driving 50, 60, 70 on the interstate. Raul, I was hoping you could walk us through this and start with just what are our crash tests and what are we testing for?
Yeah, so we have three different frontal crash test modes. In all three, our impact speed is 40 miles per hour. And that more or less represents a crash in which you are traveling down the road at 40 miles per hour and you collide into either a fixed object that's stationary or another vehicle traveling at you at 40 miles per hour that weighs the same amount.
Of course, we know in the real world that scenario rarely happens,
right.
But we can look at the real world data and see the severity of those crashes. How does that fit in with what we're testing for?
Our test speed captures the middle of the distribution of real world crashes where we know there are serious and severe injuries. We know that there are crashes that are more severe, but we are capturing the bulk of the total number of crashes. Most crashes are very low severity.
So I guess the logical question would be like, okay, if we can capture more of those crashes, why don't we just up the test speed to 50 or 55 miles per hour?
There are some unintended consequences that go along with that, including degraded safety in lower severity crashes, because what happens is your vehicle ends up being stiffer in order to perform well in that higher severity crash.
Right, and just a quick physics lesson, because if we wanted to bump up the test speed to 50, that's not a small change in the amount of energy that vehicle has to handle. That's a big ask.
That's absolutely right. Your crash energy increases exponentially with impact velocity. And so if we go from 40 miles per hour to 50, we're looking at over 50% increase in crash energy. And that is when you're already starting with a lot at 40 miles per hour, that would significantly change vehicles.
You know, we've still got 40,000 people dying on the nation's roads here in the United States. So there are obviously other things we need to be looking at in addition to vehicle design.
Outside of vehicle crashworthiness, there are many things that go into making sure that we have safe systems, on all roadways, right? So good roadway design, laws and enforcement of those laws, and driver behavior.
Right. Safe vehicles are important, but so are safe roads, safe people, safe speeds, all of that factors in.
That's right.
So, by the way, IHS does a lot of research in those areas as well. So if you've only seen our crash test videos, I'd recommend you check out IHS.org and dig into some of the research in these other areas that we can be working on as well. Thank you very much, Raul.
You're welcome.